introduction, ecumenism is God's gift and the essence of it, the present ecumenical experience and activity. I'm very happy this afternoon to be among you to represent the Church for this ecumenical worship and celebration.
Thank you.
Second, he became, the president of the Fiji Council of Churches to help bring a common understanding between the two respective groups. And three, his determination during the Pacific Conference of Churches, Chapter 7, in the Solomon Islands to strengthen the ecumenical spiritual base of PCC. He spoke with passion about the Pacific understanding of God in the scriptures in the context of ecumenism. He personally encouraged ecumenical theological learning to be a must in the context of ecumenism. I was chairing the assembly then, and I was privileged to have visited when he shared his conviction on the ecumenical agenda. Visibility has been used in ecumenical thought, but the intention is the same: to preserve the distinction between God's action as a gift and human actions as responses. The difference between the unity given and the unity sought. Looking and thinking about the spiritual energy that we use to express its ecumenical thoughts at work, we can clearly and honestly say the late Reverend Dr. Waqairatu is truly a visionary leader, whom God set aside and equipped for this particular work. I also believe that the same spiritual energy was with those church leaders whom God inspired to start this ecumenical life and journey in Fiji and the Pacific. We thank God today to celebrate some of these tangible results in our search for a visible unity in our working together under the Fiji Council of Churches, the Pacific Theological College, the Pacific Conference of Churches, and the South Pacific Association of Theological Schools. And the late Dr. Waqairatu was a member of these ecumenical institutions at various times until he passed away. His contributions are always worth building a better ecumenical life that is sustainable. He continued on through his ecumenical spirit and conviction to reach out in a new way of life, of visibility that is sustainable. In his interview with the Fiji Islands Business, titled "Waqairatu is Change Man," he shared his different areas of working together. The Green Church idea for the use of plastic and disposal of rubbish in advocating environmental protection. The reaching out to non-Christian faith by doing projects together on critical social issues. I believe this has been going on with the churches, critically working together on issues affecting Fiji and the city. Ecumenical learning and formation. The Reverend Dr. Waqairatu was a strong advocate on ecumenical education in the formation of our Pacific churches. In the last PCC assembly, he actively encouraged the assembly to continue supporting theological education as the only way to maintain our future ecumenical leaders. He himself was a product of his ecumenical education and formation. It is a process, mutual learning from other faiths and cultural traditions in the body of Christ.